Hi everyone, today we will be seeing how to create a function group and function module, and we'll browse through various tabs of a function module. So first of all, let us go to the Tcode SE37. We will first create the function group. Now this function group is a program which holds together all the function modules in that function group. So let me just create ZTMM2. And let's save this. So if you see, a function group ZTMM2 is created. Now if I go to SE38, and if I do 2, so if you see over here, there are two programs which have been created for this function group ZTMM2. If I click on overview over here, it will show me the function group ZTMM2. So the moment you create the function group, there are two includes which are created in a function group. One is the top include, wherein you can define the global variables, and the second one is the include, where all the function groups definitions are stored by default. You do not modify anything in this. However, you can define your global variables, which can be used across the various function modules in this function group over here. Now I click on activate, and we'll activate both these includes. Now let us go back to SE37, and we'll see the function group function modules which I have created before. So the first one which I have done is one function module. Let us browse the tabs. Now first one is the attributes. The moment you create a function module, it will ask you like to which function group it belongs to. And within that, then you have this processing type, regular function module, RFC enabled, update mode with how it is updated. By default, it is start immediately. If you are using a function group to function module to create a BAP, it will always be remote enabled. So always remember the BAPs are always remote enabled because you are calling them from other system. And there are some administrative parameters which are available over here. Now, the next tab is for import parameters. These are the input parameters which the function module will be taking from you as an input. You define the parameter name over here, the type. Now, the types which are type or type ref to. So you can associate it with any type, or else if it is any type ref to class object, a class interface, anything, you can pass in as an input to the function module. Then the associated type. Here you can define either a data element, a structure, or a table type, or row type, anything you can define over here. Now this column refers to the default value. You need to give the default value in single quotes over here. Now this tells you whether this parameter is optional. Right now I have not made it optional. So that is why it is unchecked, and whether it is passed by value. And then this is a short description over here. The next tab is export tab, which will be the output of the function module. Now, both import and export, both these parameters are optional. Again, you have a type over here, like you can have type and type ref to. And over here, you can have a data element, structure, table type, row type, whatever it is. And this can also be passed by value. The next tab is for changing the changing parameters. Now this changing parameters forms input and output both. And again, here you have type and associated type. Again, it is optional or pass by value. And then you have tables parameter. Now tables parameter is obsolete nowadays. But earlier it was there, and there will be many BAPIs which we will be discussing later on. They have this table types parameter, and there are many SAP standard function modules which are existing for many years, and those also have these tables parameters. Even when you are using web RFCs for certain interfaces, there, even though this table parameters is obsolete, still most of the web RFCs the stuff which is used by CPI or CPIDS, they use these table parameters only. The next one is exceptions. Exception is similar to the exceptions which you have in other languages. So if you want to, if something is not working as expected and you want to pass the exception, the output, you can define exceptions over here. And then comes the source code. So whatever you defined over here in import, export, changing tables will be visible over here as a local interface. Even the exceptions will come over here. As of now, I haven't defined anything. Now, for ease purpose, I have already written some code over here. What it will do is it will check for a global variable G underscore group. So if this global variable is not set, it will consider the input importing parameter I group as an input. If this global parameter is G group is set, then it will take this as an input and it will fetch the data. And I've just written select star from Mara into table IT Mara, which is of this type over here, tables parameter. And to demonstrate how this export parameter works and change parameter works, I have just assigned some constant values to it. Now comes the point to see where these groups, this global variable is defined. So let us click on display object list or the overview button over here. It will show you the overview of the function group to which this function module belongs to. So if you see, there are two function groups in this function module, function group, which I have already created. And this fields folder will have the global variable, which is defined over here. And here you can see various includes which are included in this function module. Now, if I click on this fields parameter, if you see, it is defined in this top include where you are allowed to define the global variables. So I have just defined one variable G underscore group of type MAKTL for convenience per se. And if you see this G underscore group, you can access it and change its values in any one of the function modules which belongs to this function group. So if earlier times when this object-oriented programming and other things were not available, instead of static variables which are used in object-oriented classes, there are global variables which are defined over here in the top include, and they can be used to pass values from one function module to another function module. So there is a second function module which I have created, which is a set group, and I'm just setting the value to some particular value. Okay, now how to test this function module individually? So what we can do is we can click on this execute button over here. So I will put a breakpoint over here to see how the values get executed. And let us click on this test execute. So I will pass a value over here for I group as 001 and see change. I'll put old val. Okay, and we will execute the function module. So because we have put a breakpoint, it will take you to the debugger. So let us see what is the value of this global variable. It is blank over here. Now, because it is blank, it will go and fetch the value for this I group, which we have passed in the input, which is 001. So it will execute the select statement over here. And if you see, there are these number of 67 entries which have been selected in the IT Mara internal table, and then it sets the value of E group variable in this step to export group, And if you see the change, C underscore change had old value as a value. And now it has been changed to new change value. Some problem is there in the debug. Okay. Now, if I execute, you will see the output over here. So the C change, it had the value old value, and now it has changed to new change. The E group is an exporting value, and we have passed the value export group over here. And there are 67 entries which have been selected over here in this internal table. So keep on watching my videos. I will discuss more about global variables in the next session. Thank you. Bye.